Atomic number 29, aka copper, and more specifically copper peptides, is a forgotten ingredient in the skincare world. It plays a major role in boosting elastin and collagen. It's a gold mine, or should I say a copper mine? And medical researchers have been studying copper peptides extensively for about 40 years now, so we have good data on their use, which is exciting. In this video, I'm going to go over what copper peptides are, how they work, and the medical literature that proves that they work, as well as how to use it for wrinkles and aging skin. So stay with me till the end. Also stay tuned with me till the end, as I'll share a hair product that has copper that you could use for growth and follicle nourishment. And real quick guys, before we get started, it would mean the world to me if you hit the like button for the YouTube algorithm and turn the bell on next to it to stay up to date with new weekly videos. So what are copper peptides exactly? Well, peptides in general are short chains of amino acids, which are the building blocks of proteins. We all have them naturally in our body, but in skincare, peptides are applied topically, either as a serum or cream, and it works by sending signals to your cells to produce more collagen and other complex molecules for supporting your skin structure, right? And you'll find copper peptides, also called ghk-cu, which is a naturally occurring complex made within the human body during times of repair. In other words, your body uses copper to repair, so keep that in mind. But as we age, our body produces less copper peptides, and your skin and hair cells spend less time in a state of continuous healing. And when this happens, aging happens. For example, when you're 20, you have an average level of 200 nanograms per milliliter in your body, but this goes down to an average of 80 nanograms per milliliter by age 60. So what researchers theorize is that if you add those depleted copper peptides back into the body, giving your body those signals to make more collagen, you may help reverse some of those signs of aging, be it in the skin or in the hair. And you all know me, I love going into the scientific literature and being specific on the actual mechanism of action for all skincare products. This is what makes my channel unique. You get the details with me. For copper peptides, once you apply them onto your skin, there are 8 things that start to happen. I won't go into depth into each pathway, but I want to point out a couple that pertain to our conversation the most. 1, they stimulate our fibroblasts, which you know helps us secrete collagen. 2, it upregulates that collagen types 1 and 3 and 5, which are huge. 3, it stimulates the skin cellular matrix, increasing the cross-linking of collagen and elastin matrices in a copper dose-dependent manner. And 4, it serves as a cofactor of tyrosinase, a melanin biosynthesis essential enzyme responsible for skin and hair pigmentation. So now that we know what copper peptides are and have a general sense of how they work, let's talk about who's going to benefit the most from them. 1, it's anyone who wants to increase their collagen production to fill in those fine lines and wrinkles. Let's say if they're already taking collagen supplements, or let's say they're using a retinol, using copper peptides in addition to these will help stimulate your fibroblasts to make more collagen and elastin, which is awesome. The second group who will benefit from copper peptides are those who just want to regenerate their skin. As we age, our skin cycles take much longer for them to regenerate. This refers back to the natural process your body goes through to shed old or damaged skin cells and replace them with fresh new ones. This graph does a good job at showing that even as we approach our 30s, the cycle extends by a week, in our 40s by 10 more days, in our 50s by 20 more days. Copper will help support a youthful skin cycle, which again is amazing. But now let's talk about how to use them. Copper peptides should only be used in their specific concentration. The stratum corneum loves them. The good news is, it's pretty hard to find copper peptides in their isolated form on their own. You need them formulated with ingredients that will boost their absorption without causing irritation or overexposure to them, which we will talk about. The ones in skincare are ghk-cu, which is highly effective in boosting collagen and elastin production. Then there's copper tripeptide 1, which is great as well, as it gives you an additional antioxidant boost and works on inflammation. And 3, newer formulations like copper palmitoyl heptapeptide 14 and copper heptapeptide 15 are good ones too. The 2 I would go with, and no, this isn't sponsored, is the one by The Ordinary. It's called Buffet Multipeptides with Copper Peptide 1, which will help with those dynamic lines on the face. It's also infused with Matrixo, which is another anti-aging gem for wrinkles. Go ahead and apply it after your cleanser, toner, and essence. Apply 2 to 3 drops onto the face and massage it into the entire face until it gets absorbed. And I always recommend spot testing it first though. And the good news is you can actually use it morning and night as well. And the second product is the Biossance one. It works as well. It contains copper PCA and turmeric, which I love. The copper peptides they use are a glycine L-histidine and an L-lysine chain called glyhislice. And you can see the copper in its true form, the blue form. Both of these will be linked below as my affiliate link if you wish to go with these ones. Both are great solutions. What I like about copper is that they work well with other ingredients too, but if you're using a retinoid, it would be wise to stagger it. So one night you could go ahead and use the copper peptide serum and the next your retinoid. And in terms of safety, they are generally safe and most people do great with them. But with that said, skin hypersensitivity to metal is possible. Some people call this a metal allergy when a person experiences red, itchy, swollen skin when they come in contact with certain metals. But for the most part, it doesn't pertain to copper. It's mostly nickel, which is why it's best to use a nickel-free razor. Gold, beryllium, and cobalt are more so tied back to metal allergies. Not so much copper though. But it isn't impossible, so make sure to do a patch test first. But let's talk about copper for hair. In this paper titled Analysis of Serum Zinc and Copper Concentrations in Hair Loss, it was found that a recent study revealed that copper plays a crucial role in the differentiation and proliferation of dermal papilla cells, which are specialized fibroblasts in your hair follicles. So not only is copper essential for the skin, the hair follicles can benefit from them as well. Not sponsored by them either, but the Divi Scalp Serum contains copper tripeptide 1, and it takes about 1 to 3 months of consistent use, but your hair follicles will be nourished by it. It doesn't leave a greasy residue either, and it absorbs pretty nicely, which is always great, and you could find that one in the description box as well. But I'm actually more curious to hear from you guys though. What are your thoughts on copper peptides for hair and skin? Leave them in the comments below, and until then guys, I'll see you on the next one. There's also an acquired biotin deficiency that comes from eating raw egg whites, which contain avidin, and avidin binds to biotin and prevents its absorption. But this can be prevented by cooking the eggs, which denatures avidin, so you can absorb the biotin and not have to worry about it. Other foods to watch out for, believe it or not, are foods like eggnog, Caesar salad dressings, and some mayonnaises that are said to contain avidin, so keep that in mind over the holidays. And some medicines like valproic acid or long-term antibiotics can change the gut flora, which can cause a biotin deficiency too, just FYI.